Hare Krishna. Don't reduce scripture to your conception of what scripture should be teaching. Expand your conception to understand what scripture is actually teaching. Many people, those who are generically spiritual or consider themselves to be pious generically, they often say that all that scripture teaches us to be good, to do good, and scripture is a book of moral, of useful moral values. While morality is taught in scripture, but scripture also teaches spirituality, and profound and often specific spirituality. So if we want to study to understand scripture properly, we can't impose our own conception on scripture. Sometimes when we come with our particular conceptions, then we focus only on those conceptions and we don't let anything else grow further in our lives. We don't let ourselves grow, we don't let others grow, and in that way we end up trapped. We end up terribly trapped because our conception doesn't expand and we reduce scripture to our ideas. What we need to do is that yes, I may have some intelligence and I may have some understanding of what the good life is, but scripture is something much bigger. If I want to understand what scripture is teaching, then I need to move forward toward understanding what scripture actually offers. That means I need to look at what is scripture teaching. So for example, in the Bhagavad-Gita, some people think of the broad dharmic traditions as polytheistic, and especially people who have grown up in a monotheistic tradition, they consider polytheism to be a naive, primitive kind of religious system. But what the Bhagavad-Gita offers is much more profound. What it offers is that polymorphic monotheism, that there is one divinity and there are multiple manifestations as well as multiple levels of manifestations. So for example, in 7.21 in the Bhagavad-Gita, Krishna, when he talks about the various other gods, it is not that like in polytheism there are many gods and they are competing with each other, but there is one supreme and there are other gods who are surrogates, who are assistants, who are representatives, and who are empowered by that one supreme god. So this is so that's as Krishna says, yo yo yam yam tanum bhakta shraddhaya architum icchati tasya tasya achalam shraddham tameva vidadhamyaham. So satya shraddhaya yuktas, that with that faith if we work, then we all can grow individually and collectively. And that is what we should be seeking in our lives. And we can understand the immense compassion of the Lord and appreciating that compassion, that if those who can't worship Him directly, they can connect with Him through other gods who are His representatives. So this is a profound system of theology which does not sit into our, fit neatly into our preconceptions of monotheism and polytheism. And that's why we need to understand scripture on its own terms, not in terms of our own preconceptions. Thank you. Hare Krishna.